Hey guys, Caleb here. This time we now have Ash.
Hello.
And I'm still alive. Don't worry about me.
So despite some sanity loss, we're still going. In case you're trying to follow along, and trying is, you know, the word here, chapter 26. Oh, the pain of Autumnale, because I so called this when she lost her arms.
Oh no, I see where this is going.
It was almost 4:02. You could have just said it's 4:00. It was good enough. The sun swayed in the distance and began to make its journey down frumpy sky. It was setting in golden haze. Shadows from the trees went to the right and across the sidewalks, while the breeze creed in he autumn air hair. Amaru was at the stove, busy cooking some spaghetti, which is what I was thinking about making earlier, but then I decided to read this shit.
Yay! I know you made the best choice by doing this instead of spaghetti.
Of course. I am filled with good choices. In a big pot, a big boiling pot. Not water or anything in it, it's a boiling pot itself.
It is a boiling pot.
She probably didn't put water in it, but...
It's a magic pot that will instantly fill with spaghetti somehow. Tales of the Spaghetti Woman. Yay! While Raichu waited at the window like a kid waiting for his ice cream cone to be served. Shut up. Stop with the redundancies.
Quit it with these stupid metaphors.
Because we're clever looking, I guess. We have to compare everything to a metaphor of some kind.
That's not clever.
No. Are you sure you don't want to play any games, Onisama? How can she? She doesn't have eyes or hands. Time will not fly by that way. The time fly by. Time will not fly by that way. The time fly by. He said, smiling, because she totally knows he's smiling with no eyeballs.
Yes.
No, Raichu sighed. What games can I play anyway? You don't expect me to play I Spy, do you? You're an asshole. But you got a good point, too.
Yeah.
She shooed her head and plunked it against the window. She shooed? I have no idea what that could be.
Shoo shoo head. Go away, please.
Yes. Distressed and sad with pain and anger. Okay.
If you didn't want to be in this predicament, then you shouldn't have had your eyes taken out.
Yeah, I mean, this whole thing was to purify you. But you're still an assassin, and they didn't tell you jack shit about God anyway.
If you want to redeem yourself, even if it's for the sake of making yourself look better, then why not save lives? Help people spare the world from cancer.
That wouldn't be as cool as being an assassin, though. Because that shows she can, like, fight people and be awesome.
She is distressed and sad with pain and anger.
Yes.
That is very, very redundant.
Mm-hmm.
That's not going to make me feel sorry for her.
No.
I can't feel sorry for her.
No, I kind of feel sorry for her when Denmark's being an asshole. But then I'm reminded that she, too, is a dumb asshole. Amaru came to her with a silver platter that had the spaghetti neatly served on it. So wait, it's done? Or is it just the noodles? There's a little more to spaghetti than just boiling the noodles.
Well, at least it's neatly served.
Yeah. He sat down next to her and held up a fork with a twirl full of noodles and sauce and meat on it.
Oh, he did finish it then.
I guess. Okay. Raichu, just open your mouth and trust me, I won't stab your gums with a four, with the letter, Caleb, with the number 4? Did you just forget to add a K to that, even though that would totally still be misspelled as a fork?
Just open your mouth and trust me.
I'm not going to kill you or anything now that you're blind and can't really stop me.
I've seen enough hentai to know where this is going.
Oh my god. This this author is so
funny. Right, she obediently opened her mouth and said, ah. Suddenly the fork was jammed in her mouth. Ugh. What are you doing? She muffled through inches of spaghetti. Inches of it, huh?
Inches of it. Oh, that's a lot of spaghetti.
That's pretty coherent for someone who has a fork jammed in their mouth.
Mm-hmm. I'm feeding you. What do you think? He asked, and he kept peeling more and more spaghetti into her mouth. Does it taste good, Raichu Sama? He gargled. Oh, she gargled. As he continuously shoved more and more spaghetti into her mouth, the doorbell rang. Ring.
The author tried to make this exciting, but it's not coming off as exciting. It's coming off as...
No, it just sounds like he's being an asshole and trying to choke her to death on spaghetti.
She is gargling on that spaghetti.
This sounds pretentious.
Oh, blimey. Who could that be? Blimey?
Since this is the first chapter I've read in this story, is this dialogue normal for this character? Blimey?
Not that I know. I mean, he's been here, what, like 2 chapters now? The 3rd chapter he's been in? He gently put the fork and plate down on the table, despite trying to, I don't know, fatten her up.
He's a very gentle man.
Boy.
Oh, yeah. Gentle.
He's a boy.
Oh, boy. Boy. Oh, dear.
Hence why I make him sound like a 90s kid.
Down on the table, while Raichu still struggling with chewing spaghetti in her mouth. Sat down there, got up, puked into the bucket. I don't know. He gasped when he looked through the window. Oh, it's the other male girl who we know is Winry, because you said it last chapter.
So she struggled chewing spaghetti in her mouth. I didn't know she lost her teeth, too.
Mm-hmm.
With her eyes.
She's looking for a dentist to give her dentures.
At this age, huh? That's messed up. A 17-year-old.
Yeah. Well, I never had really good teeth. I had, like, crowns and things by the time I was 17, so, yeah.
Yep, my entire upper jaw is full of veneers. It's quite fancy.
He chirped like a little bird. Quickly, he rushed the door open. He was already at the door. Why would he just... Whatever. Unlocking all the locks that kept them from going to the outside world. How many locks does she need? Is she some paranoid nutcase? I thought she just unlocked the one with her teeth.
Yeah, of course she's nuts. We already know that.
Good morning, my lady. He said, tying Winry's arm. She wore a red bandana over her head and a black tube top with a purple sweatshirt wrapped around her body hips. But no pants and no
her
shoes.
Her body hips. Just to be clear, which hips? It's her body hips.
Just to also mention that Winry is naked from the waist down.
Ah, as she should be.
Well, hey, what's up? She said, taking his hand and shaking like a hearty man, because she does that. Who is the girl in question of needing an automail? Oh, I see. She said, looking at Raichu's nubs. Yeah, you could definitely use that.
Damn.
I didn't just bring the materials needed for making an Amamel arm that looks authentic. I heard about her eyes, and I decided to get some glass ones for her. Just so she looks normal, you know. Because it's not like she could wear, or just keep her eyes closed or something.
Yeah, well, that is just mean. Yeah, you're not going to give her replacement eyes that function like actual eyes. You're just going to...
Well, to be fair, I don't know if they can do that in Full Metal Alchemist.
But honestly, the way that last sentence was worded was just cruel.
Yeah. Okay, thanks. Yeah. Raichu screamed.
What?
She screamed this. Why?
Yeah.
She's like a cat demon vampire thing.
Yeah.
Oh.
probably hurt the ears of the guy who made that cruel comment.
Winry sat down in front of her, taking out a wrench and preparing aught work on Raichu. All right, Raichan, prepare yourself, because typically when putting on autumn mail, people have a lot of pain, okay? Why is that a question? I know why K is a question. Why is the first sentence a question? I can handle anything, Raichu assured. Ow, she said as the first instation of metal was made. No, this takes a while, don't it?
It's been a while since I watched Brotherhood, but I think it goes a lot slower than this.
She said she could handle anything. Yeah, we saw a good example of that in the last 25 chapters, didn't we? Wow.
Well, don't you essentially go... What I remember from... I never saw Brotherhood, but I watched the first series. I seem to remember it was... To attach the autumn mail, it was sort of something like a surgery.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, that sounds really familiar to me, but this one's special.
Of course.
More canon derailments.
Well, now, see... It isn't so easy now, is it? Winry worked the wrench around, getting the metal onto Raichu's left arm. You have to attach it to nerves and shit.
Yeah.
Wiry, Irie, how long are you going to take in here? Edward, Eric, really? Okay. Burst in through the door. Man, I nearly died of heat in the car. Well, then why didn't you leave it running with the air on?
You can't have Winry without Edward Elric. You just can't.
God damn it! Winry screamed as she made a wrong move. Raichu's hair was all tangled up in her new metal arm, like the spaghetti around that devil fork that she couldn't see.
That's good recall.
Look at what you've done did, Shorty. Why is she speaking like this? Just because she lives out in the country doesn't mean she talks like a hick.
Look at what you done did, Shorty.
Well, I reckon that's a right there mess you made. Better clean it up or I'll have to get
your ass. Get your ass back in the car.
Clean it up.
She threw the wrench at him. What happened, Raichu cried. Jiggle?
Oh, okay.
What jiggled? Her boobs?
I can only assume it's her boobs, because she has no limbs.
That only belongs in script formats.
Oh, bugger. Amaru turned pale. Nothing much, you just got your hair stuck in the yellow mail. Well, I've prepared for this. She marched off into her bag. Into her bag, I see. And searched for something, because she could change sizes.
Yep. Makes sense.
Winry took out a pair of long scissors and made a snip-snip noise with them. Or why not just, like, pull her hair free of the autumn mail? I don't think it's in place yet.
Because that would make sense.
You're not cutting it off, are you? Raichu said cautiously. It's just a little bit of hair. It will eventually grow back, right? Once I get your hair off of your head. What? Are you scalping her with scissors?
Sounds like it.
Then I can work on pulling the remains out of your arm, okay?
Why is everyone in this story such a nasty motherfucker? Seriously.
I don't know, but they are. Be strong, Raichu, Amaru assured. Sorry, Raichu, Edward replied in a low, dark voice. Why would he care?
Does he know these people?
Nope. This is the first time they've appeared.
Oh, great. Okay.
Oh, no. Winry took Raichu's hair. Your bangs are stuck in here too. How? If she has bangs, they're not that long. They're going to be a bit shorter after this. Sorry. She took the scissors and started cutting away.
I'm sorry, but I just figured this out. The whole loss of limbs thing was just an excuse to show that she was having, like, a costume change. Like, the whole point was that she would get a haircut. I get it.
That is a wise observation.
Thank you.
It's fine. Raichu pretending what? That she's a good character? it wasn't
cold.
It wasn't really all that fine, right? You hated the thought of losing her hair, and if she had eyes, she would be crying a little. You were crying! You were crying last chapter with no eyes! Just because you have no eyes doesn't mean you can't cry!
Look with your special eyes!
The spelling of thought, that kind of sounds like a Klingon word.
Shukwik.
Why is it with these sound effects? Seriously?
You can remember, just... because she's blind. So she can't see anything, so she has to...
Accessible. I get it.
The author could have just written that it sounds like this. The scissors sounded like...
The scissors made a shquick-shquick sound as she snipped away the hair from the automail. There! Simple!
See? Exactly.
The scissors made their terrible noise as the cut into many strands... Yeah, strands.
Already know it's a terrible noise. You pretty much wrote that made-up word twice before the...
Shquick.
Get that it's a terrible noise.
Shquick. We're almost done, Renry said as she got around to cutting the back. Now I know I ain't no hairstylist, but you're going to look fine afterwards. And short hair does you just taste anyway, so don't worry your pretty little head. That's only apparently pretty if you have arms and eyes, according to your fiancé. Sure it will, Edward smiled.
Yeah, your fiancé, that's a total shit.
Amaru cleared up the bits of Retu's hair that was all over the floor. He flushed them down the toilet for some reason.
That's not good for your pipes.
No. Now we need to put the skin on Raichu's arm. So this is only one arm, I guess. It's not real skin. No shit. Stop telling us this. It's what they used to make dildos.
No! Dildo arms.
They're not giving her actual arms. They're just giving her dick arms.
What?
I'm gonna picture the rest of this stupid fanfiction with this character having dildos for arms.
Me too.
What?
Yay!
That's so awesome.
Are you fucking kidding me?
That's what it says.
Oh.
Winry added, "What? Nothing." She smiled. Since
this author is nastiest troll I've seen in years.
Since there will be joined and the skin will cause them to stiffen. Okay. That's not how dildos work, friend. You pretty much have never encountered one in your life. There will be no skin around the joints. No, that's not how it works.
Stop telling us about the skin, author. Stop.
Dildo skin.
Stop or I'll punch you.
Sorry, but at least you can't see it. You're an asshole. Renry wrapped and cut the skin around the arms. The skin will be stressed around the join and look funny. Sorry about that, too. But I thought you were going to have to... Oh, look fun. Sorry about that, too. Whatever. It's all fine for the sake of being able to use my arms again. Or you mean to have arms in the first place. Raichu flinched as she was still tender, why is it capitalized, from the Alamel being put on her nerves.
Which took all of 30 seconds.
Right. All right, Winry said excitedly and beamed at her work. Wow, this is the first time I've ever done this. What? What?
Okay.
But what about Edward? Whatever.
This makes no sense.
And it doesn't look half bad. They skin's rather durable, so if you still want to fight, you can. But I suggest using protection.
Always use protection!
Well, if they mean fight by fucking people with their dildo arms.
It would have helped to tell her to fight with protection. I can't even talk right because of the story.
I'll just keep going then. Try to move your new arm, Raichu. Raichu opened and closed her hand, because she can just get the handle of this first thing. while looking at it because she was used to looking at things, even though she couldn't see with the eyes she don't have, so there'd be no reason to even look at it. Well, this is working really nicely. Oh, and for the final touch, Winry forced Raichu's empty eye sockets open and inserted two glass eyes. They were both orange and even looked like cat's eyes. Because I had them custom made because I knew your eyes were special.
Your special eyes!
She even says it! I have special eyes! Yep, she ruffled Raichu's hair. Because she was a special person, I guess. Imaru sat down beside Raichu and started combing her hair. All right, Onisama. Just sit tight for a little while. I'm going to clean you up, and you'll be ready for anything. Even though you have your arms back, I'm going to stay because you still need help seeing, okay? Because she's stupid and don't know this? I guess so, considering the next line. Sure thing. I'm glad to have you here. Okay, Edward, we're going. Not like I need to receive payment or anything. Don't you ever burst in on me with a customer every again, okay? Winry took Edward by the ponytail and dragged him out the door. Bye, Maru. Bye, Raichu. Thanks for contacting me. She waved. Bye, and thank you, they both said.
I never come back.
Later that evening, Amaru left suspiciously early, even though he lives there and has no reason to leave now.
But it was very suspicious.
Mm-hmm.
He's leaving to get something hidden, perhaps by young guards.
What are you doing? Raichu said groggily, half asleep. Oh, I need to go somewhere, he paused. I promise I'll be back before you wake. Amaru, Raichu cooed. I may be going soon. I need to find my daughter. If I'm not black when you come back, I'm sorry. Because I'm going to instantaneously change my skin color.
Yep. And so, then she will have big black dildo arms.
So, right, you wait all this time to put more emphasis on your daughter. You spend a whole Christmas chapter not thinking about her. Now she matters. Interesting. You are such a good parent.
Of course. It's only God, after all. And God needs help. You know, we have to look after her. Because God couldn't function without an adult, seriously.
Nope.
That's perfectly understandable, he nodded. Good luck where you go to get her. No, it's not perfectly understandable.
Very little in this story is understandable.
She can't see a damn thing. How is she going to get anywhere without somebody to guide her?
How is she going to save her daughter to begin with without her eyes? On a rescue operation, she'd be a huge...
Okay, granted, it's a story. And even if it's far-fetched, there have been stories which have, like, blind masters who can kick some serious ass even though they are blind.
Yeah, but...
And so, at the moment, I would say she's trying to maybe do something like that. But of course it's going to fail.
Yeah.
I greatly look forward to that.
Can I give you a trophy?
I need to contact my friend Yuki to see if she can feel Elaine yet. You said she couldn't because the spirits were douchebags. And
Yuki
wouldn't allow it.
Yuki is your friend? After all, she did.
She's also technically family. She's her half-sister.
How can you call someone like that your friend?
How did she think losing her eyes and limbs was a necessary thing to get somebody back?
That would be like calling someone who burned down your house your friend. Is someone like that your friend? Raichu is dumb.
Yep. Raichu said that, and then Amaru left. Because I guess he's no longer needed for the story, so he got the hell out. Watch him be evil.
Everyone is evil.
Pretty much. Raichu used her new fingers to ring up the phone. How do you know this? Dialing Yuki's number. Ring, 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 banana phone. Do, do. Oh, hey, girlfriend. Yuki's voice picked up. I can sense that your other mail is on. How does she fucking know this shit? He called her yesterday.
Who is Yuki? Where is Yuki from?
I'm not sure if she's a character from anything specifically, but she is supposed to be an, like, angel thing. Raichu's sister.
Okay, so that totally makes sense.
Mm-hmm. That's right, it's working great, Raichu smiled. I was wondering if I could feel Tenshi Kuzu? Yes, I can. I know, but you just said that she couldn't. That it had been a waste of time. It was pointless to even do this shit about losing your things, your body parts. Oh my god.
I can tell how much you guys love this story.
You should have been here last night just listening to us, like, we are so sick of this. We want to go and do something else. We still have so many chapters left. Damn it. It was just me and him by the end of the day.
Oh, no.
Okay, yes, I can. I know where she is, Raichu. We'll need to meet tomorrow. Why not now? If you're capable of doing this, why not now?
Has to be tomorrow.
Your dad has her held captive on a remote island. I can fly you there. Okay.
But tomorrow.
Yes. Good. Pick me up tonight if you can. I have a beating I want to set on that guy. What guy? But if only Elaine's there, we'll need to take her. Wait, you're only going to beat up your dad if she's there. Otherwise, you're just going to be like, you're fine, and leave.
What's the kid's name? Is it Elaine or is it Tenshi Kuzu?
It is Elaine Tenshi Kuzu. Basically, what they were trying to do was make it like Elaine Stardust or some shit. But I looked up what Kuzu is in Japanese, and the best I could come up with was that it is the equivalent of crap. So basically, it's Elaine Angel Crap.
Fantastic.
Doesn't that just sound lovely?
That's a great name for your child.
Stealing that from my firstborn.
Sure thing. I love you, Ray-chan. I love you too, Yuki-chan. Even though you were kind of an asshole and told me that I had to do this shit, and then you ripped my arms off and I put a mask in my hands that, you know, ended up blinding me. I really appreciated that.
Yeah. Isn't she just a genius?
Mm-hmm. Bye! And Raichu hung up. Raichu continued to open and close her hand, feeling how odd it was to have machinery on her. She felt up the metal bits on her arm and sighed. Oh, well, it isn't so bad, she said.
She felt them up with her dildo arms.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
That evening, Yuki came flying in her window and broke the shit out of it. She'll have to pay the repair costs for that.
Knowing how cruel she is, she wouldn't even donate a cent to charity. So why is she going to pay for a window?
True. Her beautiful white wings flapped it, he breathed, like two sails in the sky.
I know it says beautiful white wings, but I'm picturing devil wings.
Yeah. She might look like an angel, but she's fallen. She's fallen pretty hard.
Like two sails in the sky.
I guess they, you know, came loose from the sailboats and they're just flying away.
Just flapping around out there.
Big old floppers.
That get longer with time.
Yes. She landed on the windowsill and smiled. I've come for you, Raichu-chan. So have I, a voice came from Yuki's back. It's me, Minichan! Hee-hee!
Who?
Another character. This one lost her memory because she watched Pokemon.
Yeah, that happens to me, too.
Oh, Raichu said, rushing to her window in her nighty gown. Why are you wearing that if you were expecting to be picked up and go somewhere?
In her nighty gown.
How are you guys? Good, they replied, and Raichu hopped into Yuki's arms, because it's not like she's going to be super heavy with the other male or anything.
No. It's made of carbon. Super light.
Where exactly is the island? That's capitalized for some reason. it's hardly far from here, being, you know, Japan. Like, if it... Why would Goku just go to a simple place if it's not far from where you guys are?
This often must be allergic to making sense.
Yuki exclaimed. They flew over the town, and Mina... How is Mina doing any of this? I thought she was just a normal person.
Apparently she gained superpowers all of a sudden, because Goku's here, so maybe she learned how to fly somehow.
They flew over the town, and Mina and Yuki spied on people in their houses, because, yeah, while we're trying to go and do something important, let's waste our time, and laughed on a guy. They laughed on him. They didn't laugh at him, but actually on him.
All over him.
Mm-hmm. Sitting at, not on, but at his toilet in the bathroom, reading Etchy Etchy Paradise. Because I would laugh at a guy reading porn.
Don't spy on people reading porn. That's the government's job.
The cool air was nice, and the stars twinkled beautifully, even though she couldn't fucking see them.
I like how that's in the same paragraph as the guy reading Etchy Etchy Paradise.
I think I know how she can see. She's not really seeing. She must be imagining it.
Oh, it's all a dream.
Soon, an island. A island. Not an island. A island. Came into view and gradually got closer to them. I thought you were going tomorrow, but being picked up tonight.
More continuity errors.
We're nearly there, Yuki smiled. I can't wait to see my Aka-chan.
Wait. What? Aka-chan?
I think that's supposed to be, Japanese for my child or my daughter. I'm not 100% sure. It's just more Japanese thrown into something that didn't need it. Also, that one movie, seriously, did you see that? The same movie I saw where the blind lady said, "You'll see." Really, you're having the blind character saying this.
Aww.
Poor Raichu.
I can't remember the name of the movie at the moment, otherwise I would say what it is. But Elvira had it on her show, and it was so bad, like, it was slowly paralyzing her. They glided onto the sands of the beach on the little island. How little is it? Is it, like, a couple of feet across, a yard, maybe the size of a football field, a couple football fields? Is it tropical? Is it cold here? Is
no,
Destiny
it's just,
Island?
It's just little. It's just little.
I swear to God, if it's Destiny Island, I will cut you, author.
Oh.
Do not ruin Kingdom Hearts for me.
Oh.
Bring me along.
Raichu's ears perked up because she's a good puppy rather than a kitty, and she began to hiss because she does that, I guess.
She's a kitty.
Something isn't right here, she said mysteriously, like a detective who's found a clue because she can fucking do that.
She is the worst detective.
She's the worst female protagonist.
No, that would be Jenna. But this one is trying. She is trying.
Just give her meow mix.
Meow 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 meow. Word dorks.
Okay.
Oh, that was riveting. Oh, I've only done one chapter of this and I already hate it.
Yay.
So
welcome to our pain.
Yes, now we have a Zaf and it's Levi's turn.
Yay!
I'm sure you'll so enjoy this, because you've been really loving this story so far.
I'll do my best. Chapter 27, Tears Like Mine. I can feel it too. It's sickening. Like you're drinking gallons of spit.
Ew.
That's hot.
Do you even know how spit tastes?
Well, I would assume so, considering it's in your mouth constantly.
Yeah, spit in my mouth.
If it's in your mouth so consistently, you're not going to notice the taste unless something's in it. But if you're just saying it's spit, then you're not going to tell. My stomach turns.
Does it do cartwheels?
I can do this. The island was quiet, and nothing was heavy but the thick air that lingered and moved a sad tune around the three girls' heads. Nina tried to desperately warm herself by hugging Raichu, Yuki looked around the beach. I don't know, but if I was in Raichu's place, I wouldn't let anyone touch me, or at least I'd be yelling, "Don't touch me," considering what everyone has done in the story, or said, not trustworthy people.
Yuki carrying two people?
That's what I was thinking.
I don't know.
Unless Mina is able to fly.
I don't know. But I can believe that Raichu would say anything, considering that everyone in this story is an almost complete dumbass.
Very rare. Massive idiot.
Yep.
What's up? Did someone say something?
Oh, Zeph said they were a massive idiot. Everyone in the story.
Yeah. Hey, Mimi, are you here? Raichu's voice echoed throughout the wind of the mountain.
So are you screaming this? Why? Wouldn't that alert Goku to your position?
Let's do this. I don't think she's here, and if she is she okay? Do you think she's alright, Yuki? Raichu's golden eyes twinkled. Wait, her eyes are golden now?
Yeah, because she got, glass eyes.
Oh, wait, I thought they were another... Never mind, the story's making it hard for me to remember stuff. Reflecting it, I'm not really feeling her anymore, not in my heart. Oh, wow. The suspense.
I know.
You said worried with her hand on her chest as she wore a white tunic like one shoulder outfit.
So what? It's a toga.
White tunic like toga. One shoulder outfit.
Toga.
Toga party.
Toga. Toga. It's your return.
Well, you kids, you all just missed the party of the year downstairs. I was hoping you'd be coming, Raichu. His voice was cold, then vibrated through the misty air of the deserted island beach.
Since when was it misty? How can you see the stars twinkle if it's fucking misty?
I got no clue. How do you pronounce this name?
Sesshomaru.
Oh, yeah. Sesshomaru, the vampire lord.
Why the fuck is he here? Did we just kind of remember he existed?
Has he been in the story before?
Yes.
Yeah.
Also, whatever happened to Inuyasha?
They just forgot about him.
I guess.
Raichu's veins popped out the sides of her face and she went up red.
Her veins popped out.
So wait, she went from being white or Asian, one of the two, to being black, and now she's red.
She's red now.
She's all the colors of the rainbow, but not as tasty as Skittles.
Her arms are now red rockets.
Is she a Dramora from Elder Scrolls now? All she did was snicker and wave his hands in the air.
What because he that? Was be doing something stupid like that.
Yeah. What's up?
I was just saying, alls he did, because he's...
Alls he did! What does that mean? Whatever.
Sesshomaru.
Yuki killed in her airy voice. You haven't killed her, have you?
How do you fucking kill God?
Well, in Pokemon, the god Pokemon was killed with cement, so maybe they can do that here? You know what I'm talking about?
Nope.
Well, in Arceus and the Jewel of Life, Arceus is supposed to be the god Pokemon, and one guy tried to kill him using something called Silver Water, which was basically cement. And somehow Arceus would die if he got dumped in a pool filled with cement. But I don't understand how that works, but maybe they got some...
concrete shoes.
What's up?
He's going for a little walk at the bottom of the ocean.
Forget about it!
Stupid Pokemon.
Gonna make him disappear.
Better than us, Pokemon!
Say you hello
fuck,
to
you
friend.
Fuck with Godfather Kate, we fuck with you! Nobody's gonna get that unless they've been watching the 50 Shades of Grey videos.
Hell no.
He smeared and raised his hand. I don't know, maybe I did. Ask us, he said, Hal, do you have silver water or something? They all guess. You see, Richiru, thousands of years ago, a group of people of the Shinto religion came to this very island. Okay. They all practiced the Shinto until one day they came across a small young child. Blue hair and black wings. Assuming he was evil, they pulled apart his limbs until he died.
Why would they do that?
Because they're quick to jump to conclusions.
So, however your name's pronounced, are you implying that you can kill God by pulling off his or her limbs?
Is Shinto a militant religion?
No. For last I knew, it was more of a naturalist religion.
They were just having an aggressive game of tug-of-war.
Blue hair and black wings. Edgy.
For the next few months, the crops of their land withered and fucked out.
They fucked out?
I don't think they can do that.
Yeah. First we have a squid fucking a school, and now plants.
No, we have a squid fucking a school, a sorting hat fucking Hermione, and now plants are fucking other plants.
I missed Yay. All of this?
This is so ludicrous. It started with the island and
What? I think I just missed something.
No, read the sentence. It started with the island and
then it spread.
Because the plants, they fucked out. And so then it started with the island and then it spread. Like a woman spreading her legs. Get it?
They realized the mistake they had made killing that one boy. They ended up worshipping him as and a deity in creating the
Kamimichi Shinto religion or unknown
and
god.
And they called him
or Stubbs. Unknown god, resembling that this deity they guess controlled certain parts of the earth and goes down in different forms, man.
Okay, I have to look this up because I don't think they're using that word correctly. Kami. Can somebody... Okay, there we go. Never mind. Kami.
Raichu crossed arms and... excuse me. Raichu crossed her arms and nothing in his direction. She can't fucking see him!
He's talking with his hands a lot.
I understand how that works now, but why do you care about what happens to you? On the rare moments where she makes sense.
I can't find a proper translation to this, so I don't know. Like, I know Kami is God, but I don't know Michi.
Yeah. I understand how that works now, but why do you care about what happens to me? What do I have to do with this? I came here for my king, her for me daughter. Okay, I'm going to start giving a pirate voice for Raichu then.
Called it!
I came here for me daughter, but you obviously have more of an agenda. You're a very curious person, Raichu Ketchup, and it's a pity you won't be able to see your daughter once you find her.
I thought you were alluding to the fact that you killed her.
Me too. But I have nothing to want from you. You're lying. Yuki pointed her finger at him. I can feel it in your soul. What? Whatever you think I'm doing doesn't matter. He shook his head and smiled. You're here now. He clapped his hands and a dark mist came out of the sky heading towards the three girls. Rachel and Yuki braced themselves. A large hole opened up in the floor and... Floor?
I guess and... they're a floor instead of the ground now. They're inside a building.
And the black mist grabbed all the girls, taking them into the belly of what?
Of the island, I guess.
The girls. He's taking them into
or maybe it's the Kraken. Maybe the Kraken showed back up. Or the giant squid to fuck some buildings. Because it's an architectophile.
With sounds all good. Tentacles in the hive.
Sounds good. All three of them woke up within a dark hostel room, my children, with a hint of Eva.
How do they know this if it's dark?
It's dark and hostile, with just a hint of evil. You can just barely get it on the aftertaste there.
Yeah, I know. It tastes like Coca-Cola.
Yeah, that's why I always narrate this story using this accent, my children. There is a Halloween. There was the slight light of moonlight for the use of shining in through a barred hole in the ceiling. They all looked at each other and sighed. Is it over, Raichu Chan, Yuki Chan? Stop using the fucking Arfix! Then a bird in her knees. I shouldn't have let you come along.
Okay, Yuki has fucking wings! Grab them both and fly the fuck out!
Nope, nope. Suddenly, the automail is too heavy.
That, everybody the face.
No, it would make sense, so they can't do that. Yuki said, it's my fault. I knew it was too dangerous. If you knew it was too dangerous, then why the fuck did you have your friend...
This is the same person who took her to have her arms ripped off and her eyes gouged out.
Still, yeah.
I can't decide if the author of this... quote unquote story is like a brilliant person or not.
It's a piece of shit, yeah. Not a story.
Well, we know how Levi feels about this fic.
You do?
I'm intrigued.
That's a good thing you're intrigued because it goes on forever.
Hooray!
Minas and squeezed it. It's okay. I'd rather all die together than for you to disappear and never heard of again. Minna squeezed back and smiled. Rachel felt her way to their heads and grabbed them. Okay, now, why my daddy then said... Oh, wait. Her. I get it now. Why my daddy and set family teamed up against me. My father just wants me dead and vampire guy wanted to stop the birth of...
He invited you to his wedding! He hasn't really done anything!
He's an asshole like that.
He wanted them to bring, like, a $200 gift.
That makes sense. She laid her head on the cold rock wall behind her, and faced towards the moon. I'm the key to keeping this world in the light, and bringing the god back to this earth so it can mature and set things right. I don't think I'm the right one for the job, though. Oh, no. You just figured this out now, you dumb shit. I've made too many mistakes.
You keep making mistakes.
We already know that. And I'm not even that enlightened. Again, we know this shit. Why in the world did God pick me and Inuyasha to sleep in it? That's a
because she
question.
Said that you guys were the perfect pair.
Yeah. Yeah. They're perfect. I think
yeah. She's got huge tracts of land.
Huge tracts of land.
We're all still very young, right, you? We even still have maturity to do. Can, whatever. Wouldn't have picked you if she didn't think that eventually you'd become the perfect mother. She is not a good mother. She is not. She's the shittiest parent in any fiction I've seen. Been in years that trying to be whatever the story's preventing rational thought. The moment, okay, I lost my. Oh, wait, stop asking why and start doing. Even if you turn out to be unsuited for bringing and raising Elaine into this world, you are still part of this story.
Are we breaking the fourth wall?
I don't think they're breaking the fourth wall. I think they're trying to be poetic.
It's like Never-Ending Story. You have to give me a name! Bastion!
Never-Ending Story!
Vortex! No! I'm done.
I'm drawing a picture of Zephyr.
What?
I'm like, I'm not even following this chapter anymore. I'm just doodling.
I can do this.
You can do it.
You can be the right person who turns things around and makes them right. Even if you are not the last person to do it, what you do now will aid the next mother of God to keeping this world in life.
What? I didn't realize that was just like a job.
Mother of God!
So wait, God will exist. God will exist until it doesn't anymore, and then somebody else will just happen to rebirth it?
Yeah, God's kind of a dick that way.
Okay, sure, I guess.
I don't understand, but let's continue in pretend that's... I can't even... Fuck this story, man. Fuck it.
Yeah?
If it got me into a book, I'd buy it just to... Wipe my
this
ass.
Should be published. This should be made. This should be like the next 50 Shades of Grey.
Let's start a Patreon and get this thing published.
Hell yeah. No.
Ah, yes.
I would go see this movie starring Damon Wayans.
I would
well,
too,
I was going to say, there's not... animated movies of it online.
I've seen the animated movies now.
Right, you're not even stood up. You're right, Yuki. She gently felt the metal bands around the joints of her fake arms. Even if I'm destroying me and I still need to do my part, do not give up. Yeah, on. She felt around the rocky wall until she hit the spot that seemed shallow. I shows her. Okay, you two better stay away, cause I'm about to bust a hole in this. She kept on hands on the wall. And with her other hand, she made a fist. She tried to punch a hole in the well. What well?
I think she's played Silent Hill by this point.
Yuki, I'll need you to help me. Did something just break in the background?
Somebody had a dish or something.
My brain.
That was Ash falling down a mountain.
It's
okay. We gotta keep going.
Yeah, Yuki stood behind her and began to bat her wing, concentrating all of the energy from her wing onto one spot on the wall that Rachel punched. She bolted through the wall, causing rocks from on top of them to fall on them. Yuki wrapped her wing around Nina and herself to protect them, while Rachel used her metal arms as an umbrella. What?
Hold on, what?
Something else. I can do this.
You can do it, Levi.
Yuki stood behind her and began to bat her wing.
Yuki and Minna stood in a big bright light that shone on their faces coming from a hallway through the door. Oh, right, you, Minna cried. The skin on your arms is being torn off. Kind of a waste to put the skin on arms if you're just gonna rip it off.
Soon. Yeah.
Rachel instinctively faced towards her arms, but she still couldn't see anything. We know that. She's blind. We already know this shit, you asshole. It doesn't matter to me. I can always get that redone. But later, they marched out there. Hold my hand, Rachel.
Holy my hand.
Yeah. He said, going to fall into things if you don't. Yuki, if you were a real person right next to me right now, I'd punch you in the face. It doesn't matter if you're a girl.
That's sexist! Ah!
Beat me to it!
And if I give you a nosebleed, I'll collect your blood and drink it.
I wouldn't. It's tainted.
I wouldn't. You don't know where it's been.
I don't care. I'm going insane. Bear with me. Thanks. Yuki, but I think I can be okay. Raichu held her arms and moved through the hallway. She walked for a while before she noticed that Yuki and Mina were being too quiet. Yuki-chan, where are you now? Mina's voice came from the far end of a room, and they were quite timid, like a shy.
What?
I guess a shy guy?
Like a shy.
They were timid like a shy, yo.
Raichu, can you feel them staring at you? Then, Raichu's heart began to race, and a little, who's them and they are they dangerous? No question mark at all. She got ready to fight. Yuki's voice came from within Raichu's head. Okay, now she's going insane too. The story is driving the characters insane. One chin, I need to show you, show my thing. Let me into your mind, you can see what I'm doing. And that's what Raichu did. Through Yuki's, she could see that they were rolls and rolls of incubator tubes with glowing green liquid. Inside those tubes were clones of Raichu.
What? Oh, no.
Yay, more useless characters.
Oh, did she watch Resident Evil?
No,
I think she just watched Evangelion.
Oh, maybe that too.
Most of them had their eyes closed, but some of them had their eyes open or slightly open. Every once in a while, one wouldn't have the bell if the owl were facing towards Raichu. Oh my god, Yuki, what are these things doing here? Why would vampire guy do this? Raichu buried her hand in her hand, and so do her. That's great! Shook her head. The clones shook their head back and forth in unison. Well, it seems you found your little friend. A slender man in a black outfit and white gloves with an apron came out from between some of the tubes. My children, you may call me Sebastian. I am a demon, but I am also your surgeon.
I have never actually watched that show,
I still
which didn't. Is Black Butler, but like,
oh, Black really. Butler.
At least that's what
racist.
I think it is.
I want to see that show. That looks awesome. Let's see her chin. Right to yelp! Exclamation point. Yes, ever since that vampire guy found out that you birthed the god of whatever religion, he's been trying to figure out your molecular structure and physically create you so he can birth an anti-god. Finally, something's making somewhat some sense. At first I thought, Raichu's useless. Why would anyone want to clone her? But after reading this paragraph, it makes sense.
Because she's so beautiful and perfect and everybody loves her.
No. She gave birth to God.
Yeah, so, but she's also beautiful and perfect, and everybody loves her.
She's so
and she
perfect.
Can do everything.
Oh, even better with dildo arms.
Yeah.
She's perfect. That's why I laughed when something bad happens to her. Yeah. She's not even a likable Sue. I mean, in Star Wars: The Force Awakens, the main protagonist was kind of a Sue, but she was likable. Here, the main protagonist is worthless. She is.
She is the mother of God, and you will treat her with respect.
Mother of God!
No, I'll break into her house just to take a dump on her face.
Oh, okay.
Yes, you're seeing my cruel side tonight.
Okay, guys, I think we get the point.
I'm sorry, Captain. He left. Oh, Miss Wright, you don't you think you can't sit down for a while? Have some tea? No, Raichu grumbled. I need to find my daughter. She drew out a long sword. What?
Where? She didn't take anything with her.
Where did she get that?
Magic.
Magic.
Oh, it's magic.
I'll continue. Oh dear, I nearly forgot. Hang on. Is Sebastian the character, the main character of...
The butler character, the main character of...
No, he's the little crab that plays the drums and has to make an accent.
That works.
Oh dear, I nearly forgot. Sebastian took out the long banana from his pocket and fiercely threw it at Yuki's head, successfully knocking her out.
What? Wait, what?
Oh, yeah, your long pocket banana.
I got a long pocket banana, but I'm not allowed to talk about it.
I don't think you're allowed to pull it out and throw it at people either.
Is that your long pocket banana? Are you happy to see me?
Okay.
Because the situation calls for it. Ring, 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 ring. Banana phone. Do-do-do.
Technically, I can believe that. If that banana, or if Sebastian was looking at something erotic, and he decided to use his banana, then I could, and throw it at her, I could believe it would knock her out. As profane as that sounds, but I must continue. Then it bounced to Mina's head and knocked her out too.
So it's a boomerang nana.
Banana-rang.
Yes, banana-rang.
Banana-rang. Banana-rang-a-ding-dong.
I would not want to go to the beach with this guy.
It's longer than Gandalf's penis.
I definitely wouldn't want to go to a nude beach with this guy.
I would.
Okay, everyone, let's behave ourselves for the rest of the story, even though that's impossible. We gotta try. Right. Oh, sorry. I didn't have anything else handy in my pockets, you sick bastard.
He giggled. Tee-hee.
Now that Yuki's knocked out, you're back to being blind, aren't you now?
She was blind to start with.
Huh? You... Oh.
I think she's trying to allude that somehow she had psychic sight as long as Yuki was awake.
I can keep this up. I can keep it up.
You're almost done with it. You're almost there. Just a few more paragraphs.
Yuki Chan, Nina Chan, Reiju sighed and backed into a wall. Her voice became old and angry like the bowl. I'll rip myself to shreds before you two do. There's no other reason why I was giving you any besides the fact that you would choose me. Making a clone of me will not solve your questions. What? Sebastian raised his eyebrows in questions. I would do that too. You were chosen? Wait. How do you not know? How do you not know that? She gave birth to...
I guess Sesshomaru wasn't technically there when she gave birth and God explained this shit. Korra was. Korra was there and she heard it and she's Sesshomaru's lover.
You characters are idiots.
Yeah.
Sorry, Jesse.
It's okay.
Raichu shook her head back and forth. I am nothing more than a cat demon vampire. I have something to say about it. No, Raichu. You're nothing more than the stuff I flushed down the toilet.
Like your hair.
Oh. Yeah, your hair.
No, I'm not talking about my hair.
Her hair, remember?
Oh, okay. Great recall.
It's not like the story really needs a great memory to start with.
I'll keep it up. He licked his luscious lips and rubbed his surgeon's tools in excitement. Well, you don't know everything. We'll find out. Rachel put her hand to her head and knelt down to the floor. What's wrong? Sebastian asked. Oh, did you forget that your daddy is here somewhere watching?
Whoa, kinky.
Oh, this story is so bullshit.
So much incest and voyeurism.
Yeah, incest. I can't.
The incest that hasn't really been said to be incest, but it's purely clearly, like, daddy issues because of incest.
Yeah.
Daddy wasn't there.
He didn't bang me in mama's bed.
Daddy wasn't there.
I'd add something to that, but right now, I'm feeling too much rage to add to that joke. She began to shiver and cradle her head. You don't need to tell me that. I can feel it. I can hear a mommy in my head. It sickens me so. She could feel the world start to roll, pulsate, her body twisting and turning, and all the rage building in her heart. She let out the demonic her eyes glowed red and
weak. No, they didn't. They're glass.
Grew out of her butt. Black wings came out of her black.
Wait. A wimpy brown tail grew out of her butt. No, you decided to take a shit on the floor.
She's getting swifty up in here.
Black wings came out of her black, and she snarled like the devil. Sebastian looked shocked, and in one fell swoop, she slammed her fist into the wall, causing rocks to fall down and break the incubator tubes the clones were in. All of the clones fell to the ground and began to crawl out, meowing.
That's a hilarious visual.
Those incubator tubes are constantly being filled and replaced with water, you know? The whole damn room is flooding! Sebastian yelled. He ran out of the door and tried to lock Raichu inside. Many of the clones dissolved into the hollow floor and became dust, not frightening Raichu. Others just fell to the floor and stood up and stood there, my children. But one clone came towards Raichu. She smiled. The clone stalked in a dark, almost robotic voice. I know where our daughter is.
It wouldn't be your daughter.
And I'm done. Yeah.